Hello everyone. In today's session, we'll be covering some questions of blood relations. These questions have been picked keeping in mind the level of exams of ASRB and ESIC that would be coming soon. So we've picked up five questions that we'll cover today. So let's begin. First, let's read the question. A family consists of eight members A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. It has three generations and three married couples. All of them live in one of these three cities, Delhi, Mumbai, and Chennai. T is the mother of A and E. A is the father of F and uncle of G. The one who is married to H lives in Delhi. H is the only sister-in-law of B, who is the daughter-in-law of C. F neither lives in Chennai nor with her aunt. G is the son of H. Each couple lives in the same city with their child except C and D. Okay. Now that we've read the question, we need to pay attention to some information that is given in this question. Right? It's given each couple lives in the same city with their child except C and D. Right, C and D are an exception, right? Okay. Now, why would C and D be an exception? Well, this is a family of three generations, right? So let's say this is the first couple, right? Then they have some children. We do not know their gender, so let's just take triangles for now, right? And then they have another child. Let's just take triangle again, right? Now it's given that each couple lives in the same city with their child. Okay, so this couple would be living in one city, this couple would be living in one city, right? But the problem arises, if we continue with this, then this couple would also be living in the same city, right? Because the grandparents and their son, they're also a couple, right? So they would be living in the same city, and then these, by corollary, these all would be living together in one city, which would defeat the purpose of the question, because it's given that there are three cities involved, right? That means that the C and D would be the grandparents, right? If the grandparents do not live along with their child, then this arrangement is possible, right? So we can say C and D are grandparents from this. Okay, now we have figured C and D are grandparents. In the first information that we are given D is the mother of A. That means D is female. So that means that D would be a female, C would be a male, right? The convention we're following here is that males are represented by squares, females are represented by circle, and married relations are showed by double lines. Okay, so C and D are married, and C is the male, D is the female. Okay, then they would have children, right? So it's given D is the mother of A and E. Okay, so they have at least two children, right? A and E. Okay, then we're given A is the father of F. That means A is male. So again, we'll put a square here. And since he is the father, obviously he would have a wife, right? And then they would have a child, which is F. Okay. Next, we are given the one who is married to H lives in Delhi. Okay. Not something we can use right now. H is the only sister-in-law of B, who is the daughter-in-law of C. Okay. So we are given H is the only sister-in-law of B, who is the daughter-in-law of C. So that means B can come here because daughter-in-law of C could be wife of A, right? But it's also possible that E is also male and E's wife could also be B, right? So right now we cannot put in B over here straight away. In the next line, we are given F neither lives in Chennai nor with her aunt H. Okay, so aunt H implies that H is female. Okay, this we'll keep in mind. And we are also given in the previous line that H is the only sister-in-law of B. That means both B and H are females, right? Okay, now let's try to understand. The question was saying that there are three married couples in this family, right? So if E is also married to someone and they would have a child, that would imply that there are three married couples here, right? Now, who can be the child of E? Well, we're given that A is the uncle of G. So that means G can be a child of E, right? G, if we put here, it becomes a child of E, right? We don't know actually G is male or female right now, but it becomes a child of E, right? And then we are given in the next line, G is the son of H. So that means G comes here and H comes here. Now we know H is female because it was given aunt H. That means she is a female. That makes A male automatically, right? And then the B is the sister-in-law of H, so therefore B also comes here, right? Now, our family tree is more or less complete. Only F's gender is left. Now, if you look carefully, it's given F neither lives in Chennai nor with her aunt H. So, this her implies that F is also female. Right? Now, we have the complete family tree. Now, we need to put in where does everyone live. So, we are given the one who is married to H lives in Delhi. Now, if H lives in, the one who is married to H lives in Delhi, that means E lives in Delhi. Right? That also means H lives in Delhi because we are given each couple lives in the same city, and that also means G lives in Delhi because their child also lives in the same city. So all three of them live in Delhi, right? Similarly, we are given F neither lives in Chennai nor with her aunt H. So F doesn't live in Chennai. The only options are Mumbai and Chennai. That means F along with her family lives in Mumbai. So this becomes Mumbai. Okay. Then we have CD. The only place that is left for CD as a couple is Chennai. So Chennai comes over here. Okay. So this is the whole arrangement that we have. Now we can move on to solving the questions. Okay. Question one. Which of the following is a married couple? Okay. Let's go back to the family tree. The only married couples we have are CD, AB, and EH. Okay. So I'll write them here. CD, AB, and EH. Do we have any of these in the options? Well, if you look carefully, option D says HE. So HE is a married couple. So option D would be an answer. How is D related to F? Again, we'll go to the family tree. This is D over here, and this is F over here. So D is the grandparent of F. And because we know D is female, so that means D is the grandmother of F. So the correct answer would be option B, that is grandmother. Question 3. Who is G's aunt according to the question? Okay. So we have G over here. So who would be G's aunt according to the family tree? Well, G's father is E, E's brother is A, and A's wife is B. So B could be G's aunt. So the correct answer would be B. Do we have B in the options? Yes, option B is the answer. Question 4. How is A related to H? Okay. This is A and this is H. A would be, according to this family chart, the brother-in-law of H. He is H's brother's, H's husband's brother. So that would make him the brother-in-law. So the correct answer would be option C, brother-in-law. Question 5. Identify the odd one out. D Chennai, B Mumbai, E Delhi, F Mumbai, G Chennai. Okay, let's see. First we have D Chennai. Okay, so D Chennai is a correct pair, right? Then we have B Mumbai. B Mumbai is also a correct pair. E Delhi, that is also a correct pair. F Mumbai, that is also a correct pair. G Chennai, no, G should be in Delhi, right? So here you see G is given with Chennai, where this should be G Delhi. So this would be the odd one out. So the correct answer would be option E. With that, we come to the end of this video. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand what kind of questions you'll encounter in these exams. I request you all to practice more such questions, and I'll see you in the next video. That's it for this video. Thank you.